Come on, boys, you're lagging.
It's this bloody amp.
Lieutenant. Hi, sir. The Commodore fears a revolt is nigh. His orders are to sink every goddamn pirate ship now anchored in that harbor, tonight.
It's by the governor's wishes, sir.
This is a direct order, soldier. You will take position on the grounded galleon and await the Commodore's further orders. Is that clear?
Aye, sir.
The conniving bastard. Someone ought to slit the Commodore's throat before he gets a chance to bark those orders.
You think so?
Dead in the water, otherwise.
All right, I'll kill him.
Your brains are baked. I won't take no part in killing the Commodore. Not one of the King's men.
We can't risk our good fortune, Chief. I'll be waiting for you.
Between them two, Rogers and Chamberlain. What's the issue?
Commodore don't think much of civilians, I reckon. And there's a rumor going around that Rogers is some kind of Jacobite, or worse, that he's a Catholic.
Oh, I could think of worse.
Ranting and raving about Woods Rogers, calling him a heathen and whatnot. What's happened to set them two off?
Hush, man. You don't want the governor's ire brought down on you. He's a mysterious sort.
Well, I'm much more afraid of the Commodore, in truth. He's a serious chap. No sense of humor.
ready to loose the top bolt on my signal.
Last time I was that. Clear shot.
The governor's given us a pardon, Commodore. Don't a man's word mean anything in these times?
Has syphilis clouded your mind? Why scratch and claw to protect such squalor? Your parasites feeding off the industry of honest men.
Much like King George in that respect.
Know your place, peasant! You may have taken my life, but you have not improved your own by any measure.
Does some purpose keep you talking?
If not for that heathen, Governor Rogers, I'd have seen you hanged from your own cross trees. Worm. All of you.